Hey you guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I am sharing with you guys two different holiday looks using the Urban Decay Born to Run palette. I did ask you guys recently what kind of holiday looks you would like to see from me in the coming days leading up to Christmas and the holidays, and a few of you mentioned using the Urban Decay Born to Run palette, which you guys know is my favorite palette, so I was more than happy to oblige. So I wanted to come up with two a little bit less traditional holiday themed eye looks. This one right here, which is pretty much a gold eye with a little bit of berry in the crease to match a berry lip. The other one I'm doing is kind of a teal green smoky eye, and that one is paired with a nude lip. But I hope this sounds interesting to you guys. I think both of these looks would be perfect for an upcoming holiday party or just to wear around for no reason at all, because sometimes just playing with makeup and creating a look is just fun regardless of the occasion. But before we jump into it, welcome to any of you that are new to my channel. I hope that you will consider subscribing before you leave. Hit that notification bell just so that you don't miss out anytime I upload a video. And that is it. Let's go ahead and jump into look number one. All right guys, so I already primed my eyelids with a little bit of concealer, and for eyelid primer concealer I used the ColourPop No Filter Concealer in the shade Fair 5. I then set that down with a little bit of translucent powder. I used the Rimmel Stay Matte Powder in translucent. So the two eye looks that I'm thinking of doing today, I really want to do one that is utilizing these kind of teal colored green shades right here. That one will probably be a little bit darker, a little bit smokier. I want to pair that one with a nude lip. And then I'm thinking of doing something that uses these kind of berry tones, but in a very soft and kind of subtle way, and then pair that with a bold berry toned lip. So I think we will start with the green look. So for this look, I'm going to start off by going in to my transition area with the shade Riff. I'm going to take that on my Morphe M504 brush. I'm just going to apply that slightly above my crease. Kind of pulling that color kind of wide out here. And then we're going to add some to the lower lash line that will kind of connect this all together. So let's go ahead and do that right now. So I'm going to take this brush right here. This is the Luxie number 23 eye shading brush. And I'm going to take that same color, Riff. And we're going to start adding that kind of to the outer half of the lower lash line and kind of pull up to meet where we have the shadow kind of blended out right there. So now I want to go in with my Wayne Goss number 18 brush, and I want to dip into this kind of bluish teal color right here. This is the color Radio. So I'm just taking that on the tip of the Wayne Goss brush, and we're just going to start to build this up on this upper lash line here. So I'm placing most of the color just right above this outer corner and just lightly feathering it in and a little bit up. And I'm kind of wanting a little bit more of a wing shape with this one, so I'm kind of pulling it kind of out and up in kind of a wing shape. Taking just a little bit more and just really concentrating the depth of that color just right on that corner right there. Now I'm going to go back into my Morphe M504 brush. It doesn't have any more product on it. I'm just blending that edge very lightly. Now we're going to go in with this color, which is the color Big Sky, which is a really beautiful kind of sea green. And we're going to pop that all over the lid. If ever there's a time to feel like playing with color, I feel like holidays are a great time to try. Now I'm going to take that shading brush from Luxie. There's nothing on here. I did kind of wipe it off. I'm just buffing this edge right here. And you, if you can see, I didn't go all the way into the inner corner because we are going to put something a little bit lighter on this inner corner right here. So I don't want to take that green color all the way in. I basically took it in about 3/4 of the way. And I'm just kind of feathering that edge. Now I'm going to take that same brush and we're going to dip into the darker green. So I'm just placing it right on one edge, just very lightly. And we're going to run this very closely to that outer lash line, just on that outer third, to kind of meet up with that darker shade. Now we're going to take this brush right here, which is basically just a flat concealer brush. This one is from Juvia's Place. It's their number 2 small definer brush. And we're going to dip into this shade right here, which is the color Breakaway. And we're going to pop that on this inner lid. I'm going with my pinky on that color. I just feel like I can get a little bit more out of it with my pinky. and just pop that right on that inner tear duct. I'm just really lightly kind of tapping over this edge right here just to really meld those two colors together so there's no harsh line anywhere. So you can see we have that little bit of gradient now. So the full pigment of that lighter seafoam green color starts about halfway in. Ooh, pretty. Now we're going to go into this shade right here, the color Big Sky. I want to add a little bit of this to my lower lash line. I'm going to take this one on the Alamar Cosmetics flat liner brush. I'm just kind of tapping that right across the center of the lower lash line. Now I'm just going to take a tiny bit more of that breakaway shade on my pinky finger and just kind of pop that right on the lower tear duct area. So I'm going to go back into this Luxie brush and just make sure all my edges are blended and shaped. Kind of fix this shape right here. Then I'm wiping that off and adding just a little bit more of that transition shade that we use, the color Riff. And I want to run that kind of underneath where that darker color was. Like I have a weird patch right there. So I feel like this side, I like the shape of. This one's a little bit too rounded right here. I'm just going to try and fix that with a tiny bit more of that dark shade on my Wayne Goss brush. All right. I think that's going to have to be good enough. So now we're just going to add a little bit of liner. I'm going to add some Wet n Wild liner in the color Cinema Brown now on my upper waterline. And then I'm going to add a couple of coats of mascara, the Colab mascara, and I will be right back. All right, guys. So here are the finished eyes with mascara. I think they are so pretty. I love this for a holiday look because I think it's a little bit more blue than green, but it does have a little bit of green in it, so it's just a little bit different, which I think is kind of fun. I do think, though, because it is the holidays, and this is technically a holiday-inspired makeup look, I do want to add a little bit of sparkle and intense highlight just right under the arch of my brow. So I'm going to take a little bit of ColourPop's Flexitarian on just a clean, flat shader brush. This one is from Juvia's Place, and I'm just going to pop that right under my brow. Okay, so I think those eyes turned out fantastic. I do want to add just a little bit more blush. I put a little bit on a couple of hours ago, but I put a very light amount on because I didn't want to do too much since I hadn't done my eyes yet. But this is what I have on, and this is the Bare Minerals Bounce and Blur blush in the color Blurred Buff. I want to add just a little bit more of this. I think this will work really well because I have that kind of warm transition and kind of blend. I feel like this eye, I don't know, this corner, the corner of my eye on this side is not great, but we're just, I've tried to fix it. That's the best I can do. I'm just going to add a little bit more of this blush to the apples of my cheeks. Let's move into the lips. For the lips, I want to add just a little bit of lip liner. This is Oh Snap from ColourPop. And then I'm going to add a little bit of lipstick. We're going to take this one right here from Flower Beauty. This is the color Naked Blush. And on top of everything, we're going to add a little bit of Fairy Floss Gloss, also from ColourPop. All right, you guys, so here is the completed first look. I love this one. I kind of wish I would have done this one last. I hope the next one goes as well. There's just something about this kind of more blue-toned green that I feel like for a holiday party, it's just a little bit different, but it still kind of screams holiday, especially if you have kind of a blue-toned green sweater like the one I obviously matched my eyeshadow to today. But I really love how this look turned out. I hope that you guys enjoyed this one. If you are not into this bold of a color, I mean, I don't feel like this is super bold, but I know some people that are very intimidated by color. This crease color would probably be enough outside of your comfort zone, and if you wanted to keep everything else a little bit more simple, you could definitely pair the darker teal color with this gold right here, the color Stranded, all over the lid, which would give you a little bit more of like a neutral sparkly look instead of the blue all over the lid. But I really love how this one turned out. Let me know what you guys think, but let's go ahead and move into the second look. All right, guys, back for look number two. So this one, I want it to be a pretty subtle neutral eye that's mostly going to have some gold on the lid with just a tiny pop of this kind of berry color in my crease and on the lower lash line. But I want to start off by going into my transition with a mix of Riff along with the color Weekender. And I'm taking those on this BH Cosmetics number 6 brush. I would be using my Morphe M504, but I cannot for the life of me found it. I used it like 5 seconds ago and somehow I misplaced it in the last 5 minutes, but I'm sure it will turn up. So I want this to be a little bit more subtle and soft than the last look that we did. I want this to kind of barely show up, actually. It's basically just going to help that pink berry color that we go in with next to kind of blend a little bit better. And I did, by the way, already prime my eyelids the same way with the ColourPop No Filter Concealer and a little bit of translucent powder. So I'm going to pop those same two shades on my lower lash line. And I'm putting these a little bit lower down on my lower lash line, almost down by this lower socket. All right, now we're going to take the Wayne Goss number 18 brush, and I'm going to dip into this matte berry shade right here. This is the color Hellride. I'm just popping a tiny bit on the tip of that brush. And we're going to just run this kind of slightly above where my natural crease is, because I want this to just barely peek out above my natural crease. I really wanted these holiday looks to be something a little bit different. I mean, don't get me wrong, I think Christmas time is definitely a good time to pop on a classic red lipstick. So many people have done that look. I'm sure there's a million tutorials out there on how to do a holiday red lipstick look, so I wanted to do something a little bit different. All right, now we're gonna go into the gold. This is the color Stranded, and I love this color. It goes with any color inside this palette, which is crazy because there are so many different colors inside here. This gold, I feel like, can be paired with anything. It does have a little bit of warmth to it, but it's not overly brassy. I'm gonna take that BH Cosmetics brush, and I'm just gonna kind of blend of berry color just a little bit more. All right, now I'm going to go in with this brush right here. This is from Juvia's Place. This is their small buffer brush, and we're going to take the shimmery version of that berry color, which is the color Wild Heart, and I'm just kind of putting that on the tip of this brush, and we're going to run that very lightly under the outer half of the lower lash line. Get a little dangerous in making you look a little bit sickly. So you absolutely could skip this step and just run maybe one of these bronzy colors on your lower lash line, or even this matte brown right here, this dark matte brown. And I may end up adding a little bit of that dark matte brown just so it doesn't look straight pink. So I'm going to take the color Punk, which is that deep warm brown right there. And on that same brush, which I did just wipe off, I'm taking that just on the very most tip of the brush. And we're going to run that right against the lashes. And this should add a little bit of depth, and it should also tone down that pink color and just make it a little bit more kind of plum toned and wearable. And then with that same brush, I'm taking this kind of on this outer corner and just kind of buffing that slightly in through this outer corner as well. Just wiping the brush off and just kind of running that right under this edge just to make sure everything's nice and blended. So I want to add just a tiny bit more depth just right to this very corner. So I'm going to take my Morphe M507 brush. I think I want to combine the color Punk with the color Hellride just to create more of like a purpley brown. I'm going to do that same thing just right on this outer corner. There we go. That's I'm wanting. All right, so I think that's perfect. You can go back in with your gold. If you feel like some of that gold needs to be intensified, you can add a little bit more. So I do want to add a little bit of liner. I'm going to take the Persona liner in the color brown. I'm going to add a little bit of this to my waterline, a tiny bit to the outer corner of my upper lash line. Then I'm going to take, again, my Collab mascara, add a couple of coats, and I will be right back. All right, so there are the eyes with mascara and liner. And now let's go ahead and work on the lip color. So I went through my lipstick collection. I wanted something that was basically very close in color to these berry colors in this palette. I did find one that was pretty close that I think is still available, and it is from e.l.f. This is one of their, I think they're called their matte lip crayons. This one is in the color Wine. So let me go ahead and just swatch it for you guys. This one is a little bit lighter than I kind of wanted. So let me just show you guys the swatch compared to, I mean, I don't know, that's pretty dang close. So this is going to be kind of our main lip color today, but I wanted to add this color kind of to the outer part of the lip. I kind of want to do a very like ombre kind of lip. I've never tried this before. We'll see how it turns out. But this one is also from e.l.f. This is their Velvet Matte Lipsticks, and this is in the color Berry Bordeaux. It's a very deep kind of purpley vampy color, but I'm wanting to line with this one and then go with this one on the main part of the lips, and maybe even lighten things up in the center with a little bit of the nude that I used in my last look. We'll see. We're just going to kind of play with it and see how it goes. So I'm going to wipe off the gloss that I have on from my last look. And then we're going to start off with a lip brush. I'm using this one from Morphe. This is the Morphe MB number 19. And I'm going to take the Bordeaux Berry color. And we're going to use the brush to kind of line the lips with this color. All right, now I'm going to go in to the matte lip pencil or crayon. I will link these down below. I can't remember the names of these, and my internet is running so slow right now, so I'm not going to bother to look it up. I'm actually uploading a video right now. I'm going to add this one in the center. I'm going to go back in with the brush and just kind of go around. Edges again. A little bit more of a high maintenance kind of lip look. You definitely could just use one of the two lipsticks. You don't need to use both. But I just wanted to try something a little bit different. So I want to go back into the darker shade and just add a little bit more to the bottom center just to give it a little bit more dimension now that it's kind of been covered up. Again, this is the Berry Bordeaux. To wipe off that lip brush, and we're going to go in to the Flower Beauty Nude Blush color. Is that what it's called? Yeah. Naked Blush. And add just a tiny bit. Right there. So now I want to kind of take a look at my cheeks. I really feel like I need a bit of a berry toned blush on. So I think the color that I have that is going to go the best with this, and it is in the Hourglass palette. This center shade right here is probably the most berry toned shade that I have. So I'm just taking that center shade on my Luxie tapered highlighter brush, and we're just going to add a little bit of this. Right. I want to kind of keep that on like the outer part of the apple of my cheek. So I do want to add just a tiny bit more of that berry color to my crease. So I'm going to take that BH Cosmetics blending brush. I'm going to add just a little bit of this to the tip of that brush, and we're just going to dust that right above my crease on this outer half of the lid. There we go. That's better. All right, guys. So here is look number two, all finished. I really love this one as well. I love this berry toned lip. I kind of feel like on my camera, it's looking a little bit more less purpley berry. In person, it's a little bit more cool toned. I think my white balance might be off just a little bit, but really love how this one turned out. I love the gold eye with just a touch of berry in the crease. And I love this lip. Once again, you could definitely just use one of the two shades. You really don't need to go overboard and go buy three different lip colors to create something like this. But of course, you could find something similar from pretty much any drugstore lipstick brand. Just something a little more berry toned I think is really fun. Let me know what you guys thought. I'd love to know which look was your favorite, but I really hope that you guys enjoyed this video today. I hope it was helpful for you guys. I know a lot of you do have the Urban Decay Born to Run palette, but I'm quite certain that you could find similar shades in other palettes. But hopefully it inspired you guys and maybe got you excited for an upcoming holiday party, or maybe just to wear this around your family on Christmas Day, because I know a lot of us will be in pajamas, but sometimes I like to just get festive and dressed up. Either way, I hope that you guys enjoyed this one. Thank you all so much for stopping by. And before we close things out, one more reminder to you guys, be sure that you are subscribed before you leave. And that's all I have for you guys today. Thank you guys again, and I will see you all in my next video. Bye. Forgot to film the thumbnail pose for my first look. I had this great idea. A thumbnail with the green look and a thumbnail with the berry look. and they'd be mirror images of each other, and I forgot to do it. Dang it.
This color right here, this is the color.
I don't even know if that did anything. Did that do anything? I have millions of corally kind of peachy blushes. Maybe not millions. Okay, that was an exaggeration.